Hey team, what's happening? It's your boy John Denton. If you didn't already know, listen, exciting times. Future's new record, High Off Life, is dropped. The reason I'm speaking quickly is because some mother is sawing outside with a circular saw and it's really fucking noisy and it's going to ruin the video. You won't be able to hear it when we're listening to the music. So this is going to be high on vibe, hopefully, unless the record's trash. Low on talk type of reaction. But if you want to see the whole thing uncut, please do go and check out my Patreon. It is up there, uncut, as with all album reactions going forward for team members. Plus, going on there, you're getting exclusive album reactions for a month, guys. It's the entire support structure for the channel, so please do go and check it out if you want this uncut in its full extended version. Guys, please do subscribe if you're new. Follow me on Twitter and Instagram. Can we get, I'm going to say 4K likes on this one. Every time I say that, I normally hold up the wrong amount of fingers, but I did it right this time. 4K likes on this one. Future, High Off Life. Let's do this thing, guys.
Yeah. That yellow Lambo outside, but when I trapped in the sun, that green Ferrari sitting outside when I couldn't make fun. I gave the plug to my nigga, I gave the game to my son. You need to learn the recipe, gotta put a socket on connect. I get bored.
The fucking beat is incredible, dude. Just the fucking expanse of it. Ooh, I got tingles. I've actually got tingles. Goosebumps. Look at my hair. Like, you can see that. Fuck it up.
When I couldn't make fun, he wanted to be a superstar. I bought my magazine for his birthday. Got my clock hold more than 17. Ooh, Dr. Atkins likes some beans. I microwaved a pound. I never cut the lean. I can't be a role model, cause I'm a trapping king. That yellow Lambo
out. This fucking song. This song straight away. I can't be a role model. I can't be a role model. Because I'm a trapping king. I mean, people are reaching out and kind of wanting this guy to be a role model in some ways, and he just ain't that fucking guy, is he? Is he?
In the sun, that green Ferrari sitting outside when I couldn't make fun. I gave the plug to my nigga, I gave the game to my son. Had to buy me a car, living life the largest. Trying to avoid these charges, don't know your heart.
Listening yesterday to Beast Mode, an amazing record in itself. Fucking guy with a saw. Honestly, I mean, that was a great record, but the fucking level of engineering here, just as Future's got that much bigger, and we're hearing like the levels engineering can get to from this, from the Weekends After Hours, even from Tool's album last year. Dude, it just sounds something else.
Yellow Lambo outside, but when I trapped in the sun, that green Ferrari give away a neck. That yellow Lambo outside, but when I trapped in the sun.
ATL, Jacob. Big old jet, yeah, getting this rich, yeah. Straight out the crimp, yep. Straight out the trend, yep. Gold Coast, I'm on gold mode. We driving every single car you want, sending the dog home.
Everything about this track is just nasty. That beat is nasty. The way the fucking, whatever the instrument is, it's like syncopating with the rest of the beat is making it sound really offset, and so you got that kind of like uneasy feeling to it. And then just the stuff he's talking about. All my fellas geeked up in a room, etc, etc, etc. This is a nasty album. There's luxury to it. I'll talk about the cover art in a minute after a couple of songs. I've got some thoughts on that. There's luxury to it. There's almost a kind of heavenly, religious element to it. But I think we're supposed to be seeing Future as the religious icon, to be honest.
Court side, I'm sitting at the game with a Glock in my pocket. All my niggas bang, brrr, clear out the couch. Yeah, I feel like the cover that red and I know I might give me. I thought on the animal pit and it got me bougie.
To me, this feels like a real slap in the face that anybody would call this guy mumble rap. One, you can clearly hear everything he's saying. And two, there's substance in all of this. You know, he's talking about a life and he's doing it in a way that matches with the music. There's a nastiness to it. And it's very much him in his, like, it sounds fucking great, to be honest.
Pray, I'm sitting in the dark and got shades. Take out the talents and go to space. Hot tit tit.
Strong start, man. Strong start. I was worried, and I still am. There's 21 tracks on this record. Now, two of them are both Life Is Good, but still, it's a long record. I always worry about projects that are this long with this many tracks, but if it can keep this standard up, we're going to have no issues.
Southside on the track, ooh. Yeah.
In a penthouse in my room, ooh. I touch the sky, yeah, yeah. I just woke up with a dime, holding a 9-5, yeah, yeah. Off the top rope, Andre the Giant, yeah, yeah. I just pulled a brand new fountain on my...
Andre Legend never came off the top rope, but I know what you're saying.
I don't owe no nigga, cut a $5 million check, I blow that nigga. Perform with my drum, you must don't know me, nigga. Got a third red bitch down in Texas, nigga.
Again, this is that contrast between the filthy grime of the old life and the fucking luxury and extravagance of the new life. Bar for bar, almost bar for bar.
Yeah, got the rolling face, same Kansas City, yeah, yeah. I'm just a walking drugstore, don't you be minding me. I spent 10,000 on a fit and I got that iron on me. Ooh. I'm on a whole nother wave, I'm surfing in on.
Spent 10,000 on a fit and I got that iron on me. Got that iron on me. Nice.
Ferrari. I just been sipping, I'm dripping, I'm spilling, I'm shitting on everybody. I got 10 kilos on my wrist. And a bando with a chick. My Jimmy Choo Sando, cause I'm rich.
Right, yeah, I mean, a simple track, the beat slapped, Future sounded good on it, and it kept it short, which I think was smart for that track, just because it didn't have necessarily substance to be longer, the beat didn't go in enough places to be longer. But again, you can't fault the engineering, you can't fault the mixing and mastering on this, it sounds incredible. And like I say, if we're going to keep this standard up all the way through, we're not going to have a problem with 20 tracks, we're really not. Let's touch on the cover art right now. So, it's an interesting one. Black and white photo, Future, arms out. Not Christ-like, but sort of celebratory. But with a lot of space. A lot of space above him. So, that sort of kind of indicates to me that he's basically almost holding a congregation, whether it's like a cult or a church or something like that, just because the space above him creates the image that he's in a large space. But if you look at the thumbnail in the YouTube versions, it's cropped in. And so you don't get that same sense of scale to it. So you don't get that same sense that he's kind of holding court in front of some sort of congregation or something like that. Obviously, got the women in the background blurred out, and you can read into that whatever you want to. But yeah, it's quite a striking piece of art considering that the vast majority of the cover is actually empty.
Solitary diamonds, solitary jewels, where the bitches shining, looking like the moon.
New watch, don't tick. Dripping Louis V, made a movie and brought another film. It's a daddy, pick a time.
Love that sound effect in the background. It's from something else. I've heard that noise before, but again, I like that weird kind of music in the background. I thought this was going to be a straight off easy sunglasses situation, but yeah, I'm being picky. I'm being picky because there's a lot of track.
Coronavirus diamonds, you can catch the flu.
You're really hoping we don't get the coronavirus bars for much longer, the quarantine bars. I know everybody's got to get it in at the moment, but like, the problem is coronavirus and quarantine do have a kind of a nice cadence to them, so we're going to hear them in a lot of projects this year. Understandably so, but you know, just want to get on with the music.
If that pussy lose, running or they gunning, cause ooh, I got the juice. I've been thugging since the youngin' brought the word to school.
Sipping on codeine, got my screws loose. Making all this money, got my screws loose. Kill you and your friends.
It was good. I felt like it was going to be immense, but it just felt maybe like it needed a little bit more time in the oven, maybe a little bit more going on in production, maybe a little bit more work on some of the lines in there. Travis's rhyme pattern on his last verse there was just kind of all over the shop. But there were still moments like when they went back to back and then Future took it up an octave. Oh, very, very close to Sunglasses situation. I think I'm being too picky. If these were all individual songs, I'm sure all four of them would have probably had Sunglasses by now. But long way to go.
Hatbox. What up, boss?
It's the first time we're seeing Metro on the track.
Cut on. Crash Kikers, dude. Yeah. Crash Kikers in the hood.
Bro, that classical guitar. I'm taking it back. That classical guitar.
Crash
Kikers. Fuck it out.
Hatbox.
Get comfy.
What up, boss? Cut on. Crash Kikers, dude. 100 snipers, I dip the ice and go. Ooh, I step out ice and froze. I hear professional, who had deja vu, I know.
Sounds like, I said classical guitar, but I don't actually know what instrument that is, because it sounds like the fucking soundtrack to The Last of Us, the instruments that are used on the soundtrack to The Last of Us.
In my interview last night, I was going up. I was offended to
some flight.
I've been going up. It's a ritual. Passport, and we going up. Like some animals. Eddie the car got me cack. Can't stand it.
Can't stand it. Won't enjoy life if it ain't toxic. There you go. There you go. Sums it up.
Right, you need to ride Striker. Before the Ferrari Spider-Man, I had to ride Striker. I taught my young niggas how to slide. Go and get a Striker.
Yeah, I'm Striker. tracking down a suspect in a bank robbery this morning.
That bitch is you, Hank, huh? Whipping up far, huh? Driving like a tank, huh? Smoking on pressure, huh? Straight out of pound, huh? Crazy ass shooter.
Rob your bank.
Level of musicianship in that song, that production with that beat switch, which I mean may have well been like a chopped and screwed version of the original beat, because it sounds like the same instrument but slowed down and then all out of tune and everything like that to create the mood of being fucked up. People don't understand, man. People don't understand.
Niggas be kicking in doors. One of my niggas ain't got no soul. One of my niggas trapping out his house.
I was about to say this is a bit more simple and it's not hitting me as much as the other tracks, and it's still probably true, but now the guitars come in and the instrumentation, or again, it might still be that same instrument as we were talking about before, the stringed instrument, regardless, it doesn't matter. It's coming in now and it's giving depth to the song, and I like the fact he's just repeating that first line. He's trying to make points. I'm not saying it's on the level of the other tracks, but it's more to it than I thought originally.
Got rich off swag. One of my niggas got rich off hoes.
Yeah. Well, I won't be singing along to that one.
I was posted with demons. You ain't did shit I did. Came off the block, I was posted with demons. You ain't did shit I did. Bitch is Catholic. I give zero fucks. You can worship the devil. Bitch is driving these bricks.
You talking about? I don't give a fuck if the bitch is Catholic. I give zero fucks. We can all tell. We can all tell, mate.
The preacher daughter selling pussy, bitch don't make me rich. I might have fought a little doubt on the strength of, because it was late and the nigga was lit. If the streets don't kill you first, nigga, it's gonna make you strong. I done came from out the dirty nigga, bitch. Came out the block, I was posted with niggas. You ain't did shit I did.
Okay. Yeah. A lot going on in the production. It's quite a repetitive track. Not my favorite so far.
Yeah. Motor in the back with a truck in the front. Poking on gas, 2-5 in the blunt. Popping new tags, it's 1-1. I got them chopsticks, ain't going to lunch. I'm at Donna's. Count on my llama, you call me Obama. Ripping that bird like the number one stunner. Got her. Came out the tribal hood, nigga Romada. Motor in the back with a truck in the front. Poking on gas, 2-5 in the blunt. Popping new tags, it's 1-1.
Yeah. That piano in there, the high register on the piano, driving the beat, his flow driving through the beat, that line there at the end. I mean, I can't say a word for word, came out the trap, a hood, role model. But he just cuts through with a little line like that, and you're getting good insight into his kind of mindset at the moment, at this stage of making music.
Lambo, there's not a coffee. Motor in the back with the truck in the front. Poking on gas, 2-5 in the blunt. I was so high on my mind, I thought I wasn't gonna see tomorrow.
Yeah. Okay, I think we needed to switch up in pace. It sounds like it's gonna be it straight away.
Reporting straight out of the slums. From rags to riches, I got me some bitches, and I changed up how I come.
The new one had me a baby.
Baby. Out the jungle, I conquered and made it.
And still don't feel like I'm famous. Feel like I can be a trillion now.
Yeah, I'ma be the one that they talk about. Feel like Chopper.
Yeah, we definitely needed this switch up in pace. I think I like the melody on this one. I like the slightly slower plays. I like the bit when we're going back to back as well. I think they work pretty well together. And then yeah, you got some funny lines in there. Just a necessary change of pace. That's it. Got Thugger on the next track as well.
Wish I had a curl on silk. I hate to see my sister suffer. You can never put a price on how much I love her.
Wish I had a cure on sickle cell, I hate to see my sister suffer. I mean, you get these insights, don't you, into Future's mindset, into exactly where he is at any point and what he's thinking, along with everything else. And like, a lot of it feels like his own drive to get to where he needs to be or to justify his own mentality. But you do get those moments of honesty and openness that I think do end up letting you into the other side of the character a little bit more. That's how I feel anyway.
I came with my brother, yeah, yeah. It's asleep on the floor, yeah, yeah. It's kicking the door, yeah, yeah. Hey, trap money, hey. Snow bunnies, hey. Trap money, hey. Quick star, hey. Red fire, hey. Money cars, hey. Cook, hey. Non-stop, hey. Choppers making Judah Harlem shake.
YSL, hey. Saint Laurent, hey. Smart Curve TV.
I'm sorry, this sounded like The Last of Us again in the beat with those strings there. I'm all for it.
Let it spark, ay. Grab a G, huh, ay. The chopper could pop it, just feel it, mill it, walk, ay. Ay, ay, reach your tongue with a cup.
Ray Charles, ay. You can still see him shine. Red Razor, ay. Count through trap.
What do you think of that Young Thug feature? Because what I like about this track is the beat, is the strings, is the mood that it's creating, and then the hypnotic verses from Future. And Thugger, I don't know, sounded a bit phoned in to me, to be honest. He was offbeat quite a lot. He wasn't singing. He didn't sound as good as he normally does. And now he's not on it again. So it felt like kind of, what was that for? That's how it felt to me. So now we're back with Future and it's just a better song again.
Good time, play with Rex, trap star. Red fire, all the
Yeah, I thought that track was going to go completely off, especially when Thug came in, but a bit of a disappointing feature for me from Thug there, I got to be honest. The rest of the track worked, but again, didn't really go anywhere towards the end.
Yeah, yeah, I'm trying to go back in time, watch it freeze up.
The way I'm shining every day, you might get blinded. I'm out my mind every day, I feel like flying. Hold up, gotta cover up my war wounds, no time to be sold. Flawless clarity, blinding my demons. You giving life a new meaning when you dreaming. On the block, we were scheming.
Okay, I thought this song was kind of going to go nowhere, but then over and over, got to pour up, got to roll up, got to cover up my war wounds, no time to be sober. Flawless clarity, blinding my demons. You giving life a new meaning when you're dreaming. I mean, there we go. Some lyrics in there, some substance in there. And then that combined with the piano, which kind of sounds a little bit like the piano in Changes by Tupac, is giving this song a bit more meaning, a little bit more depth than I thought it was originally. So yeah, every time I feel like the album is just going to settle into that lane where every song's going to sound too similar and you're thinking, why isn't this a 14 track album? Why isn't this a 12 track album? To be honest, it is changing it up enough. I probably still will get that feeling by the end of it, just because it's a lot of tracks in a similar style to listen to all in one go, and I'm all about kind of filtering out and getting the high quality stuff in there, and the rest can be bonus tracks or whatever, or just leave them on the cutting room floor, honestly. But that's not necessarily how he wants to put together this project, and you got to respect that, I guess.
No flying, it's the road I took, it was cloudy, it was foggy. Pour four, and I'ma smoke up like a Marley. It was cold, I remember days I was hungry. Bringing up, getting paid, nigga getting cocky.
Yeah, song's good in the end. Yeah, if you were in the business of cutting tracks out of this album, you wouldn't actually cut that one off. That actually acts as like a pretty good centerpiece to the album, I think. Coming right in the middle of the 21 tracks, giving it a very different mood.
Driving in a car, smoke an ounce in 60 minutes.
Just pray for a key, as God sent me a bird. Got the drop on my ops, I'm never gonna say a word.
I learned to hustle, yeah. Flex, I done doubled up my cup. Can't explain the way I grind, can't explain it. I could have failed, I turned it up and went executive.
Just pray for a key, as God sent me a bird.
Yeah, I actually like the light and shade between the verses and the chorus on this one. Not a standout track so far, but decent album track.
Like a summer, keep it one out.
Just pray for a key, as God sent me a bird. Got the drop on.
Alright, keeping it 1,000. Used to pray for a key, that's smart.
The kitchen, driving in a car, smoke an ounce in 60 minutes.
Pray for
a key. Right, sound side on this one, too comfortable. I'm going to get comfortable. I'm going to give myself a little minute. Just take a breather. I can understand why Quint used to take a break. Admittedly, I'm not jumping around the place. I'd smash the background.
Bitch, don't get too comfortable.
Here we go.
Better not get too comfortable.
See, at first I thought he was talking to a woman, but now I feel like he's maybe talking to himself.
4 or 5 holes up a minute, I'm gaining.
Maybe not.
Yeah, got a roll with a chopper with a certain amount of bling. Exclusive, put in a Rolls Royce intervention. It's hard to stay sober when I'm spinning. It's hard to stay faithful when you're winning. Showing you grateful and independent. Fuck all the danger.
Yeah. Don't think it is so much about talking to himself anymore. It's hard to stay faithful when you're winning. Maybe a little bit.
3-4 steaks on a chinchilla bean. Got a cup full of mud and a drink and a saline. Yeah, can't think for yourself. Gotta think for the team. That's tangible.
Tell me how you get this comfortable. You ain't a wild animal. Just waste my time. Pretty and fine. The way this girl's designed. Hope she can read my mind. Bitch, don't get too comfortable. Better not get too comfortable.
The beat is absolutely phenomenal on this track. The beat's phenomenal. And it's really interesting trying to interpret exactly what he's saying, because I think I am right. I think he is saying both things, and also probably talking to other people that aren't necessarily women in his life as well. So it's kind of what the triple meaning there. But yeah, this is another track that would definitely make the shorter album cut. Definitely. I got Uzi on this one. Let's see what he brings. Okay. More of an Uzi beat.
Hello. I won't ever call back. If I hang up, I mean it. Yeah, that mean it was all bad. I think I'm better off leaving. Yeah.
She remind me of a pearl. Yeah.
I like the beat here. Nice mix up from everything that's been coming before. Much lighter. And yeah, Uzi sounding good here, actually.
That girl says she a vegan, but I swear that girl still know how to eat me. Why keep talking about me?
It's another feminist anthem we got on this record.
Me, I ain't never been a G.R. late, so your bitch pull up, so make her cream. And you know I do this shit just for myself. But
look at my neighbor, Fred. I think she just might be an Arabian. I already fixed me a piece. Yeah, she eat it, I know I'm a beast. I know I've been leaning, I know she been through time for stress. I don't have time for disagreements yet. Too many girls with a car, they got them all in line, they fiending it. You chasing nut like a squirrel, yeah.
I can't believe these guys have female fans.
Parking icy watch, whoa, whoa, whoa. California, whoa, whoa, whoa. I can't icy watch, whoa, whoa, whoa. California, whoa, whoa. On I-10 with a low, low, low. Got a pound on the back seat, I'm a driving drugstore. Money stretching and lasting.
Yeah, I like the beat on this one. It feels like a bit of an album track. It's not exactly a standout.
You're there to see all of the real raw shit, but you ain't paying.
Okay.
Well, I got the Kevin.
Interesting title on this one. Hopefully we'll see a different side of Future now.
Lord forgive me, I've been on the rampage, grand ripping,
riding in the
Rolls Royce, yeah, yeah. When the tater's over, we're off, then I pop me one, ain't no reason. Gucci bucket hat for all my heathens. Temporary distractions, ain't no grieving, cup was heated. Canary yellow star, girl, shine on my demons. I feel it in my bones when you take it out my seat.
It's incredible. This is incredible. I know it's like aimed at him talking to his girlfriend at the time, and given the subject matter of a lot of the rest of the song was obviously, you know, not the best guy in a relationship, but just the cadence here, the fucking delivery, the beat is obviously incredible, but the impact this is going for is something else, man. I will take it back a little bit, actually.
Canary yellow stone, girl, shine on my demons. I feel it in my bones when you take it out my seat. I want to leave pain in my attitude is vicious and it's lethal. Came off the avenue and ran into a deep. Better kill my demons. Heading out on my
falling in love with revenge, hoping that'll kill my demons. What a line that is.
So I'm in this, believe. Give me glory, give me glory. That's victory. I'm gonna drop your name. I the trust, but I got my dope degree. They persuaded me, they gonna try to persuade you. Leave. Had laid in it, played in it, stayed in it for weeks. Mistakes like earthquakes, they can break us up. Rampage, Grand Reaper, riding in the Rolls Royce. Yeah, yeah.
I don't need a ghost to write my promises. It's interesting. Wow. Amazing track. Amazing track. It said on the Genius, I've got the lyrics open just to have them open. And it said this was actually the formal ending of the album. I don't know if that had been released or that information had been put out there. That makes sense. So how do you follow that? So I'm going to keep it in my mind when I get to the end of this, because there's still a few more tracks that the rest are supposed to be bonus tracks. And this is supposed to be the project as it is, even though there's no other version of it without these other tracks. There's two versions now of Life is Good. Now, normally, when I've heard a song before, I will listen to it again in the context of the album, but I've heard that song so many times, and the remix as well a few times, and given how long this is, I am going to skip them this time. Obviously, there are reactions to both of those on the channel if you want to look at it. I won't normally do that, but it makes sense to do that this time. So I'm going to go straight to Last Name now.
I can go to sleep, I'm paranoid, and it's way too many homicides. Bought 100 guns, got my nigga slide, my bitch every night. I don't know her name, she wanna have my child.
At now, knowing I'm involved, but we gon' slide back when it's dying down. I don't know who else no more, you look crazy.
I like the raw honesty of this track.
Broken hearted for my bitch every night. I don't know her name, she wanna have my child.
The hood mentality feel like you can go through anything.
Got my nigga slide, step into the bank.
Yeah, this and the last track showing that kind of bit more introspective, bit more thoughtful, bit more damaged side of Future, which is interesting. Another good track. Thought Lil Durk sounded good on that. Not really heard much of his music. We work well together again. So, yeah, I think that was for something that's not necessarily supposed to be on the album, but fit pretty well.
I'm a tycoon, that's why they hate me.
This came out already, didn't it? But I don't think I actually heard it.
I'm a tycoon, that's why they hate me. Throw the sheets, I'm going crazy.
Kind of surprised this one came out as a single, because it's pretty, like, bland for his music. It's just kind of, like, pedestrian, middle of the road. Strange one to do as a single. That's obviously why I didn't even hear it. I think it's probably the worst song on the album, to be honest.
Fuck these niggas up. Yeah.
What is that instrument?
Dang, three choppers sitting in the car. We play it real safe.
It sounds like the music from the Yoshi games. That's funny.
50 mil, bagged in my safe. That's a gray yard. Fuck the bitch. Seen her with a man. I had to play it all. Why stick shit? Big shit. Baby, it's the big fish. All these VVS's in my necklace, in my wrist lick.
Bitch, try to rape me. Try to put my cock out. I got murder money, so this shit can get hushed out. Pure J,
This song's been out since July last year. I never heard it before.
She broke our heart. She think we still dang. Three choppers sitting in the car. We play it real safe.
Right. Like I said, now we've got the Life is Good remix, which I've heard before as well, along with Life is Good. I'm going to kind of take the project as tracks 1 to 16, I think, when scoring. Because obviously Tycoon, I didn't think it was a very good song. It's been out. 100 Shooters has been out since July. I had no idea that song even existed. I think that was around the time my previous channel was falling apart, so God knows what was going on then. And then I don't know if Last Name was out before. That felt like it belonged on the project more. And Life is Good is a very good track. But yeah, I think such a strong start, and it did sort of plateau a little bit, I guess, in the middle. But you've also got tracks like Harlem Shake, which I didn't think the Young Thug feature was very good, but the rest of it was good. Up the River, which ended up being kind of a strong centerpiece for the record. Accepting My Flaws was a really outstanding track. I don't think it kept up overall to the standard of those first few tracks. I'd probably say my favorite tracks are Accepting My Flaws and probably Riding Strikers with the Metro beat and the beat switch in there, which was a killer. But yeah, Travis feature was okay. I think Touch of Sky, High Tech, Tech and Trapped in the Sun were a really strong opener. So overall, if I'm going to give a first reaction score to this record, I think just, honestly, if I'm just taking those first 16 tracks, with Accepting My Flaws being such a beast of a song with amazing production and quite powerful lyrics and kind of undercutting a lot of how Future is speaking and the rest of the album and a lot of his personality, I will drop an 8 on this album. It may be one that over time ends up slipping below that. It may be one where some of those tracks end up being like real classics that you keep on playlists for years. So yeah, I'm very keen, as always, to get your thoughts on the record. If you've seen this on YouTube and you wanted to see the full Listening Party uncut version as well, remember, please do sign up to my Patreon. It's on there, the $5 tier. All album reactions going forward will be in their unedited form over on the Patreon. That's the entire support structure for the channel as well. But yeah, let me know your thoughts on the record down below. Let me know your favorite tracks. Let me know your thoughts on the last track as well, and Future in general. Guys, can we get 4,000 likes on this video as well? Let's get that one pushed out into the sort of wider YouTube thing. Keep this channel growing. And if you've got this far and you haven't subscribed yet, please do just hit that subscribe button. Getting those numbers up every single day. Oh, and follow me, Twitter and Instagram as well. Should be sliding across the bottom of the screen. Guys, thank you very much for watching. It's been a long one. It's been an epic. But I've enjoyed it. I've been John Denton. I will catch you on the next video. Stay safe. Peace.